Hello and welcome to a very beautiful morning right along this lake. And I just woke up from a really good sleep in this Harrier. I'll tell you exactly how we landed in this place and why we chose the Tata Harrier. I'll also show you what my sleeping setup was and how was my sleep overall. But let's get started from the very beginning. There are three main areas we had identified for camping. The first was very close to Mumbai near the Gorai beach. The other was the Pavna Lake area. And the third was towards Gujarat. This belt has a lot of lakes in this area. The first option that we had seen was the Kalam beach area, the Gorai Kalam Virar stretch. It was hosted by this company called Tambus. As you can see, it's a little bit fancy. You're basically camping within a resort, so it doesn't have that natural feel, so it didn't go with it. The other option that we had was to camp next to Pavna Lake. As you can see, this is again a very fancy setup. I would definitely recommend this one if you are going with your parents and want a little bit more comfortable place to sleep. Try this thing out. This is called Moonstone Hammock. Has a really good setup. But again, since we wanted a little bit raw, adventurous sort of a trip, we didn't choose this one. The last place that we had kept in our shortlist was near the Kohoch Fort. This is called Kohoch Camping, and we spoke to the owner and this seemed like a very basic setup, and this is exactly what we wanted. Time for the biggest reveal in this video, the sleeping setup. For reference, this is how the Harrier looks like with its rear seats folded. And now this is our sleeping setup. I'll show this to you in portrait mode so that you get a better understanding of the width and the length of the sleeping area. What I did was I placed two yoga mattresses side by side and then placed the blanket on top of it to create an almost flat sleeping space. However, as you would remember, there was a small hump where the folded rear seat meets the boot floor. To solve that, I placed this bed sheet near that hump to have an almost flat sleeping area. Also, while sleeping, I closed the rear boot, so this excess mattress had to be folded away to allow that to happen. It was already 11:30 PM and I wasn't very comfortable driving down this road at night in a two-wheel drive vehicle. I had also heard that a few cars had gotten stuck on this road. However, the Harrier was completely unfazed by this trail. There were some points where the Harrier felt a little bit too wide for this trail, but it was always sure-footed always confident and never did it feel that this was more than the Harrier could handle. The first thing that we did after reaching the camp spot was set up a fire with the help of some wood and coal. If you are wondering why do we fan a fire, it is to ensure that more oxygen flows to the fire and the wood and the coal burns properly. And the end result to that is you get these really hot embers that you can use for barbecue and for cooking. We were planning to cook pizza at our camp, but the camp owner had this grill which he used to cook this really nice barbecued paneer and other vegetables, which was really great. Next, we started to cook our pizza. Now, I don't know whether it was the surroundings or the fact that we were really hungry or that we actually cooked a really good pizza even though it was a little bit burnt, but the pizza really tasted amazing. By the time we were done eating, it was already close to 1 a.m. So we quickly moved stuff from the rear seat to the front and laid out the bed. It didn't take long to set it up. And that's the best part about it. So having some rice before I go back to sleep. I packed this rice before I left my home. And an important thing if you are sleeping in the car is to crack the windows a little bit. This is to ensure that there isn't excess of carbon dioxide in the car. There have been cases where people have lost their lives. So that's it. First time sleeping in the car. Let's see how it goes. See you tomorrow. I just woke up from my sleep of around 3.5 hours of the total 5 hours that I was in the Harrier. Overall, I was able to sleep for much longer than I had imagined. I didn't expect to sleep for so many hours given this is the first time that I'm sleeping in a car. But the sleep wasn't great, to be honest, and that was because of three reasons. First is that I'm a little bit taller than the space that the Harrier provides. I'm around 5'11" and the spaces is around 3 to 4 inches shorter than what would have been comfortable for me. So my legs were always jammed against the rear door or the rear hatch. This can be solved because there is some space between the rear seat when it's folded and the front seat. You can move the front seat forward, but because we didn't have a
ply or something that we could put between the two. So that space was empty. We could have utilized it better and come better prepared for sleeping in the Harrier. The second reason why this wasn't great is because the part where your back is, that is the rear part of the seats, that is a bit uneven. So there is a rod there, and then there are a few holes on the left part of it. So because of that, even though we did put a yoga mat on top of it, it was still uneven, and my back was never comfortable. So that was the second reason. The third reason was that at around 4 a.m., a few bikers came, and I'm not sure if they could see that we were sleeping in the car, but they set up fire here, right 3 to 4 feet away from the car. And I was a bit surprised. I was worried for the safety as well, because there were around 4 or 5 men, and also they were playing some music here. That's when I realized that they are probably safe. But still, the noise, the fire, just light because of that, all of that combined. They were here for around 45-50 minutes, so I couldn't sleep during that time. Overall, I would say we could have been a little bit better prepared, but the experience was better than I had imagined. But all of these compromises are nothing compared to the view that you get once you wake up.
Our trip had come to an end. It was time to pack things up and say goodbye to this place. That's it from my end in this video. In the next one, we'll try out some other location, some other car, and a better sleeping setup. Let me know if you have any ideas on either the sleeping setup or the car, or if you have any great locations in mind that we could try out. Thank you for tuning in. Have a nice day ahead.